I have the feeling that the intention at the authorities level is to increase productivity and to promote intensive and extensive agriculture and to have big farms and a lot of tractors and to have a huge amount of products being produced here in Romania and exported all over the world.
In fact, being myself an agronomist, I have a view on. I think that we need, of course, to have an intensive agriculture, of course. But what kind of intensivity are we talking about? The current so-called intensive agriculture is intensive in chemical inputs, in machinery. In things that are depleting, right? They are mainly intensive in fossil energy. The intensivity that we needed to be based in activating and reinforcing the ecological natural processes, okay? And it is the way to increase the yields. I agree, we need to increase the yields, but the method to reach this yield must be based on activating the ecosystemic functions, boosting. So we will not any longer use chemicals to sort of replace what biodiversity need to produce. Okay, there is one example that can be given to illustrate what I'm saying. I think that the conventional so-called intensive agriculture, which is in fact intensive in fossil energy, as regard to fertility, which is the thing which is most important in agriculture, you need to fertilize. But the so-called modern, which is conventional, and for me now it should be removed, it consists in fertilizing the plant. In good agriculture, you don't fertilize the plant. You fertilize the land, and it's the function of the earth, the soil, to feed the plant. And what do you have to do? You need to give some biodegradable material to the bacteria that are going to consume that, digest that, and release the nutrients that the plants do need. So it's possible, and there are many places that I could show you where it's happening, where you have far higher yields under organic farming than you have under conventional. If you look per hectare, in fact, the yields under the conventional systems have not been increased since 1990. Okay, and the only example of rising of yields has been reached using alternative methods that are in the making, because of course there was very little. It's very recent that there is investment in research in this new conception of ecological intensification. Okay, so of course the result can't be expected to be here yet, no? But now there are investment. There is a new policy for agronomic research in France, for example, which is targeting this, no? To create this doubly green revolution, that will be a green revolution like the previous one by its same to increase the yields, but will be doubly green because it will use green methods. Okay?